Yesterday we have studied about the laws of indices. These are basically from your 7th standard, okay? And today we are giving you some examples for practice. So the first is law of multiplication. The examples will be based on law of multiplication. So here you should understand the first thing is that you should be well familiar with the basic operation, that is addition, division and subtraction of integers. So first let me take the examples of multiplication, law of multiplication of indices. So this will be a first example, 6 raised to 2 into 6 raised to minus 3. Second example is 7 raised to 5 into 7 raised to minus 7. Third example is 5 raised to 3 minus 3 into 5 raised to minus 2. Fourth example is 1 by 6 square into 1 by 6 cube. You don't worry about the base, whether it is 1 by 6 or any other base. And the fifth example is b raised to 9 into b raised to minus 3. So these are the examples which we are going to solve now. So let us solve this first example. Okay. So the first example is 6 raised to 2 into 6 raised to minus 3. So how you are going to solve this example is that you are going to add these two powers. Okay. So it will be 6 raised to 2 plus minus 3. And then what will be the answer here? 6 raised to 2 minus 3. And the answer will be 6 raised to minus 1. Okay. So this point should be remembered, that you should know very well that while subtracting, we are subtracting the smaller number from the greater number and giving the sign of the greater number. And these are the concepts which you have already learned in the 6th or the 5th standard. Then the next example which we are going to solve here is that this is the third example which we are going to solve here. So let's solve this third example. So the third example is 5 raised to minus 3 into 5 raised to minus 2. So what we will be doing, we will be adding the two powers. So 5 raised to minus 3 plus minus 2. Then the answer will be 5 raised to minus 3 minus 2. The plus and minus sign, when it is removed out of the bracket, the minus 2. It will be 5 raised to minus 3 minus 2. And the answer will be 5 raised to minus 5. So these are the examples for the multiplication. Now let us take the examples which are based on the law of division of indices. So the first example here is a raised to minus 6 divided by a raised to minus 3. Second example is 5 by 2 raised to minus 7 divided by 5 by 2 raised to 2. Third example is 9 raised to 6 divided by 9 raised to 3. Then fourth example is 7 raised to 5 divided by 7 raised to 5. Fifth example is 9 raised to 2 divided by 9 raised to 6. So these are the examples which we are going to solve for division. Now let us solve this fourth example. So the fourth example is 7 raised to 5 divided by 7 raised to 5. So what the answer here, the answer how we are going to solve it, we are going to subtract these two powers. So what will be obtained after subtracting? 5 minus 5. Okay. And the answer will be 7 raised to 0. And we have already studied yesterday that in the laws of indices, a raised to 0 is equal to 1. This is yet another law for the laws of indices. So what is 7 raised to 0? 7 raised to 0 is 1. Okay, you can solve this in another manner also. This is the other way. Instead of using laws of indices, you can solve it in this manner. 7 into 7 into 7 into 7 into 7 divided by 7 into 7 into 7 into 7 into 7. Okay. So these numbers, they will get cancelled, or simply 7 raised to 5 and 7 raised to 5. If you are logically thinking, your logical thinking is very fast and you are thinking very in a proper direction, then you can immediately get that this will be 1. After observation of this problem, those who are clever students, those who are intelligent students, they will immediately get the answer 1. Okay. So this is the method in which you are going to solve this. And then we are going to solve this last example, that is the fifth example. So what is the fifth example over here? So the fifth example is 9 square divided by 9 raised to 6. So 9 square means now what we are going to do here is that we are going to subtract these two numbers, that is the two powers. So 9 raised to 2 minus 6, and it will be 9 raised to 2, 9 raised to 6 minus 2, it is 4, and we are giving the sign of the greater number, that is 6. So the answer will be 9 raised to 4, or the negative power of 9 raised to 4. Manner we are solving this these examples, we are applying the laws of division and multiplication. So fourth and the fifth we have already solved. So you go for the first, second and third problem. You solve this for your homework. So these are the six problems which you should solve for your homework. Now let us take the examples of power. So a raised to 0 raised to 1, this is the first example. Second is 5 raised to minus 3 raised to minus 2. Third example is 6 raised to 2 raised to 5. Fourth example is 9 raised to minus 3 raised to 2. And fifth example is a raised to 3 raised to minus 1. So let us solve here this fourth example. So fourth example is 9 raised to minus 3 raised to bracket raised to 2. So we will multiply this minus 3 into 2. This these powers will be multiplied according to the law of power. These are the products which will be taken. So 9 raised to minus 6. This will be the answer to this fourth problem. Then the fifth one. Let us solve the second one. Okay, second one. 5 raised to minus 3 into minus 2. So it will be coming out to be 5 raised to plus 6, or you can simply write, because minus 3 and minus 2, it is plus 6. So you can simply write 5 raised to 6. So these are the examples for laws of indices in which the power is considered. Now let us consider more examples in which the bases are different. So all you have to follow here is that these are the two similar signs, minus negative signs, and the multiplication of negative signs, it is positive. Here also you follow this, that this, these are the laws which you have studied in 6th standard, that is minus 3 into minus 2, it is minus 6. So in this manner you should be well familiar with these laws of addition, multiplication and division of integers, so that you can solve the indices, the problems of indices accurately. Now let us take the another example. So these are the two examples which I have solved. Remaining three you have to solve for your homework. Now let us take another example in which we are considering the different bases. Different bases are considered over here. So let's take these examples. So these examples are, first a into b raised to, let's take here example 3 into 2 raised to 3. Okay, second example is 5 into 2 raised to 2. Third example is 6 into 3 raised to 3. And fourth example, 2 into 3 raised to 4. So you have to solve these types of examples also. Fifth example is a into b raised to 2. Okay, so how you are going to solve these examples? So these examples will be solved in this manner. So here we will solve the example, second example we will solve here, 5 into 2 whole square. So after solving this example, we are going to give this power to 5 as well as 2. So 5 square into 2 square. So it is 5 square is 25 into 2 square is 4, and 25 into 4 it is 100. So in this manner you are solving this problem. You are just distributing the power to 5 and 2 also, both these numbers. And in the next step, what you are going to do is that let us solve this fifth example. Okay, as it is written, a into b raised to 2. What you are going to do is here, what you are going to write here is that in the fifth example, a square, let us write first the problem, a into b whole square, then it will be a square b square. So in this manner, this example also you have to solve. So this is the example which is based on the multiplication, that is a multiplication of indices with the different bases. And I have given you now, today I have given you 9 examples for solving for your homework. So in mathematics, practice is very necessary, and therefore today you have to solve these 9 examples in your classwork notebook, and which will be checked by the teachers when you come in the school. Okay.